Think of the movies that really defined your childhood for you. Now think of the one name that has been attached to nearly all of them, including a couple of tiny, low-budget productions like Star Wars and Indiana Jones, no big deal. Give it up for the president of Lucasfilm, Kathleen Kennedy. You?
Woo! I am really good. Boy, wasn't this morning fun?
Oh my goodness, so many wonderful things.
So good to be here with everybody in person again. It's kind of hard to believe.
Yeah, we were just talking backstage about how wonderful it is to be able to get all of these fans together in one place again after so long. It's just, there's no energy like it, like having you all here in one room. It's wonderful. And you know, so many big announcements this morning. So many big announcements as of late. You know, there was the big Vanity Fair piece where so many things were talked about. And I just have to know, with all of these things that we know are coming, what are you the most excited for in the Lucasfilm slate for 2022?
I'm excited for so much that's going on. I think what you guys saw this morning is evidence of there's just such variety to what's going on and such exciting expansion that's happening in the galaxy far, far away. And the most important thing is we're bringing in people that are just having a blast being a part of this. So I think that's what's been so inspiring. And I think there's nothing better than Star Wars to escape into right now, when everybody is experiencing a lot of tough things happening in the world today.
Yeah.
So if Star Wars can give us a little bit of hope and optimism and something to escape into, I think that's something we all want to do.
Yeah. Yeah. And you know, talking about the last few years, you know, there's still been stuff coming out. You know, you've been releasing The Mandalorian, you've been releasing Boba Fett. Like, it's been a regular release. You've kept to that schedule, but over the last 2 years, that must have been challenging. How has it been making things over the last 2 years?
Well, I have to really give a shout out to our crews and everybody at Lucasfilm, because the resilience everyone's had trying to work around COVID. You know, the amazing thing is in these 3 years that we experienced COVID and shutdowns and just, you know, a lot of challenges, we created 68 hours of television somehow in the middle of all of that. And it's a real testament to the people that we work with.
Yeah, and as you're expanding, you know, and putting all of these new things into production, one of the things that I loved about, you know, some of the interviews you've done recently is talking about, you know, keeping this expanding and thinking about, like, all of these new places to go, you know. What's the main driving creative force throughout all this? Because as you're expanding, there has to be a creative through line for everything, yeah. Right?
You know, I think first of all, the thing that we really aspire to constantly is quality. That's something each and every filmmaker, storyteller who comes and works with us, and that I would say is across the board, whether we're creating games, publishing, or we're making television or working on our movies. And that's something I think is really important. We also talk a lot about what are the values that really distinguish Star Wars. What is it that everybody says, oh, that's Star Wars? And I think it is hope and optimism. I think an aspiration, those are the kind of stories that we're trying to tell. That's what we're trying to perpetuate. And I think that that's the gift that George Lucas gave us many years ago.
So you're talking about creating 68 hours of television, right? What are the opportunities that you have now working more in television than you ever have before versus working in film?
I think we can really do a deep dive with characters. Mm-hmm. We can also experiment. As you can see, there's a huge amount of variety to what we're doing. We can move through timelines, even though we want to make sure that these stories actually continue to inform what's come before, but also surprise us what happens further down the timeline. So That's what we aspire to. That's why I use this word now, persistency. It's kind of persistent storytelling. Mm-hmm. We're not necessarily trying to build trilogies and that kind of thing, because television has really opened the door for us to explore so many different kinds of stories and characters and do it in a really in-depth way, which is really fun.
Yeah, it's been wonderful just getting to live with these characters for much longer periods of time than we've ever gotten to before, you know? Instead of getting to spend 2 hours every couple of years, we're spending 12, 13 hours at a time with these characters and just learning all about them. And it's been wonderful. It's been wonderful to be able to live in Star Wars a little bit more than we ever have. Yeah. I have to know, with all of these new characters that you have been introducing since the last celebration, who is your favorite and why is it Grogu?
It does have to be Grogu.
It has to be Grogu. It has to be Grogu. And you know, I'm sure we're interviewing some people this weekend that are a little bummed that it's Grogu and not them. But it really is. The little guy has taken everybody's heart. Like,
yeah, and it's amazing because it doesn't matter where you go in the world, he's stolen everybody's heart. And anytime he appears, like I'm sure you guys felt this when you saw the trailer that we showed this morning. I mean, he's just impossibly cute. I mean, come on.
Sometimes he drinks a little soup, Kathy. Yeah. Have you seen when he drink a little soup?
Yep.
It's very good. It's very good.
I think it's the little tiny hairs on the top of his head, yeah. Especially when that gets backlit.
Yeah.
I mean,
He still has his little old man hairs.
Yes, he does.
You know? They come in early for them. Oh, my goodness. Well, I have to know, everything that that has been announced, everything that's going on for the rest of the weekend, is there anything that you want to tell the fans? Is there anything they need to know that they haven't already seen?
I think the Andor, yeah. I gotta say, that show is awesome. I mean, you have no idea what's coming until you see that. You're gonna be really, really excited. But I don't want to single anything out, because everything we talked about today, I think you're going to find each and every show and all the new characters we're introducing are just fantastic. So I couldn't be more excited. I couldn't be more excited than to see your reaction to these new shows. So yeah. Can't wait.
Oh,
and can't wait for tonight.
Yeah.
That's going to be great.
Oh, my goodness. It's going to be a party tonight, isn't it?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, man. Where are we all watching? Where are we all? Kathy, give everybody your room number. Where are we all watching?
It is very funny, Anthony.
It is always a pleasure being able to talk to you, Kathy. Thank you so much for stopping by.
Thank you,
stage.
Everybody. And this is so much fun. Continue to have a good time.
We've got more
Thank
Star
you.
Wars Celebration Live presented by Geico in just a minute.